Hello, Love Radio Network family. How are you guys today? This is Pastor Dawn Churchill with Gaining the Master's Edge. And so what we talk about is mindset mastery every single week and how it applies to our daily life. So I'm so excited to have you here with me today. Today is message 4 in a 6-part series on overcoming fear. And so I'm just going to get right into it. I'm going to share something that I shared on last week's episode. And so it is this. There is a very real enemy prowling around, seeking whom he may devour. Satan is the epitome of fear and cowardice. From the moment he was cast down from heaven and forced to crawl on his belly, he became fearful of one of the greatest creations of God himself, and that is mankind, you and I. See, we were made in God's image and created in his likeness. No, we're not God, but we do possess a measurement of everything that he is because we are his children. And not only that, God gave us authority and dominion in the earth as we walk in alignment with and under his divine kingly leadership, dispensing his goodness, his pleasure, his light, and his glory into every corner of the earth. So the reality is that when fear or anxiety begins to hit you regarding whatever circumstances that you might be going through in your life, understand that it's coming from a very real enemy. But the funny thing is that he honestly is the fearful one, and he is projecting it onto you. So Satan's greatest fear is man. If mankind truly rises up in our true identity as beloved sons and daughters of God, made in his image, created in his likeness, possessing God's DNA running through our veins, then Satan's gig is over. And so that's where I want to start today's podcast from. And so if you haven't checked out the first 3 messages on overcoming fear, I definitely recommend that you go to loveradionetwork.com. If you will find my name and face, Pastor Dawn Churchill, and you will be able to see all of and listen to all of the previous podcasts that we have done in this series. Okay, today, what I'm really going to talk a little bit more about, though, is the opposite of fear, which is peace. And so I want to make you aware of really how the enemy begins to wear you down. So he uses fatigue, failure, a sense of being forsaken, or even fear. So what happens when you become really fatigued by the circumstances of your life? Or what happens when you feel like you've failed in a situation? Last week, I gave the example of someone that lost their job. Or what happens when you feel like everybody has left you, or everyone has abandoned you, or no one is there to help? What can happen is that fear can creep in through those open doors. And we've talked about how the enemy creeps in with fear in many different ways, mostly through past significant traumas. But just the everyday cares of life can allow that opening, that chink in our armor, so to speak. But the reality is that the joy of the Lord is supposed to be our strength. The Bible says that perfect love casts out all fear. And if God is for us, then who can be against us? So I do want to pause here real quickly. So many times we as America, especially here in the United States of America, we have a very purpose-driven culture that is always trying to achieve something greater. Now, let me say that I am a strong proponent of pursuing your calling, pursuing your dreams, pursuing everything that God has for you. But in our culture, we tend to do that from a perspective that I do not believe is in alignment with our identity as sons and daughters of God and co-heirs with Christ. And so let me share what that is. In our culture, you have to do certain things, to have certain things, to be somebody. I'll give you an example. So in other words, you have to achieve through education, hard work, what have you. You have to achieve certain successes in order to be known as having a certain amount of influence or authority, or having certain luxuries or possessions. And then once you have achieved a certain amount, and then you have a certain amount, then all of a sudden, your identity is known as being someone significant, being someone who is strong and courageous, being someone who is able to do X, Y, and Z. But that is a very, what do I want to say, me-centered culture. And it's also, it comes from a place of insecurity, of not knowing who you are to even begin with. Now, in God's kingdom, we work from a place of knowing who we are first, knowing what we have that is available to us, and then doing what he's called us to do from that perspective. So I'm going to give you the opposite view. When you have spent enough time renewing your mind with the Word of God, and you truly come into alignment with the fact that you are a magnificent creation of God's design. You are made in his image, created in his likeness, and there is nobody else that is just like you. Just like every single snowflake is slightly different in design from every other snowflake. Don't know if you knew that, but it's true. The same thing is true with us, men and women that cover the globe. Why we are all made in his image, we all have our own special sauce. And what I mean by that, it is the unique combination of God's qualities within us that create the personality or the person that we are. And so, but as we begin to understand how deeply loved we are by God, how deeply affirmed and approved we are by God, how he has anointed us with specific gifts and talents and abilities, not for creating our own kingdom here in the earth, but for extending and magnifying his kingdom in the earth. But when you come from a place of you already know your value, you already know your worth, because you are completely satiated and satisfied and content in your relationship with God, and that relationship is so overflowing. The Bible says that out of our belly shall flow rivers of living water. It doesn't say a little bitty stream, it says rivers. When we operate from that place of identity, then we become aware of what we already have. So we become aware of our inheritance. Financially, we are supposed to be operating from the inheritance that God has already stored up for us in heavenly places, that we are a co-heir with Christ. And it is from that place of knowing that we begin to execute and do the things that he's called us to do in the earth. So if you can see, this is a very different place of identity. Instead of having to do and achieve and then gaining things that you have, and then that causes you to become or be recognized as someone special or influential or what have you, we start from the baseline of already knowing who we are. And then knowing what resources of God that we have to operate from, and then from that identity and from those resources, we actually do the things in the earth that he's called us to do. Now, I'm not sure why I went through all of that today. However, we were talking about overcoming fear. And I believe to overcome fear, we do have to overcome those insecurities that, if we were to be honest, all of us have at least one insecurity, at least one place within us where we do not necessarily feel confident or strong. But God does not want us to operate from that space. The Bible says that God has not given us a spirit of fear or cowardice, but instead he has given us a spirit of power and of love and of a sound mind. Now, I hadn't planned on going there today, but that power first of all, is the dunamis power of the Holy Spirit. So the moment that you accepted Jesus Christ into your heart and you repented of your sins and you invited him into your heart so that you could have this covenantal relationship with God, at that moment, the dunamis power of the Holy Spirit came in and your spirit was reborn. So this magnificent miracle working power is operating within you at all times, whether you are aware of it or not. And so when God says that he didn't give us a spirit of fear, but he gave us a spirit of power, he is referring to the power of God. The same spirit that rose Christ Jesus from the dead lives and dwells and breathes in you every single day, even if you are unaware of it. And the only way that you can draw on that power is to become aware of it. And that comes in that secret place. But so God has given us a spirit of power. But then it says that he's given us a spirit of love. And it took me many years to understand how love and fear are actually opposite ends of the spectrum. The Bible says that perfect love casts out all fear. So from my own experience, I'm just going to share with you that the more that I have come into alignment with the fact that I am a beloved daughter of the Most High God, who loves me to the moon and back, who thinks I am amazing even when I do stupid things, who forgives all of my sins, heals all my diseases, and is continually molding and shaping me more and more into the image of his son, Jesus Christ. As I became more aware of his love for me, like, the love, the type of love that covers all sins, the type of love that says, you know what, baby girl, just get up one more time. I'm going to give you not 2 chances or 5 chances or 10 chances. I'm going to give you 1,000 extra chances to get back up and do it again, if that makes sense. And so from that place of really having an experiential, tangible knowledge of the love of God, it is from that place that we no longer have fear. So from that place, we don't have to fear criticism from other people because we are secure. We are rooted and grounded and secure in his love for us. We don't have to fear whether or not we have the ability to do this or that or this or that, because we know that the same spirit of God that raised Christ from the dead lives and dwells in us. We also know that the sons of God, it says that we are led by the spirit of God. And so as you begin to come more and more into alignment with your true identity as a son or daughter of God, it is from that place that you can have victory over every area of fear, anxiety, doubt, worry, etc. And so, as I said at the top of the hour, the enemy's tactics are to wear us down with fatigue, with perceived failures, with perceived when someone, you know, leaves you or doesn't help you, you feeling forsaken. But God says that he will never leave us or forsake us. But it is through those doors, through past traumas, that the spirit of fear begins to come in, set up camp, and then literally take over our identity. And then that can result in fears that become phobias or neurotic tendencies. And we don't want to allow fear to have that big of a place in us. So what I said I wanted to do today was I wanted to talk about peace, because in my redhead world, peace comes from the presence of God, and the lack of fear comes from God's peace, as well as me knowing that I am held in the hand of a beloved Abba Father Daddy who loves me to pieces. And he doesn't just love me that way. He's no respecter of person. As crazy as he is about me, he is crazy about you in the same way. So I want to take us to Psalm 91, and we're just going to look at a couple of verses. And then I'm going to release and share with you just a couple of prophetic words that the Lord gave to me in my prayer time. So Psalm 91, hopefully it's a familiar passage for you. It says that he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Verse 2 says, I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. In him I will trust. And so I really just want to start there. So it says, he that dwells in the secret place. Dwelling in the secret place is really just you having that vibrant, tangible relationship with God. I remember when I first got saved, about 30 years ago or so, I had this image of me talking to God off and on all day long. And I remember thinking, I will never be that kind of fanatic Christian. That's crazy. Well, 30 years later, that's the exact type of Christian I am. See, God is not just my father. He's my friend. He's my shepherd. He leads and guides me where I'm supposed to go. He's my provider. He provides everything that I have need of, not just tangible resources and wealth and money, but he provides love and joy and peace and contentment. Like, he really is my all in all. But the only way that he has become my all in all is by entering into that secret place. It says that those that dwell in that secret place, that word dwell literally means to recline and lay down and to make your home there. It means, in fact, I'll go ahead and I'll share this with you real quickly. That word dwell it means to sit down. It means to remain. It means to stay. It means to sit down in rest, recline, basically pull up the couch or the chair with a cup of coffee and just begin to rest. So as you begin to enter into that secret place, not just every day, but kind of off and on all day long, it says that you shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. That abiding is synonymous with peace. It means that it causes you to rest from dis-ease or anxiety or fear. It also causes a ceasing to all grumbling, complaining, and murmuring. When you are satiated in the presence of God, you can live your life from a place of rest. And when you have rest in God, you then can have authority over any storm that you may walk through. I'm going to say that again. When you have rest in Him, you then have authority over every adverse circumstance that you could ever experience in life. So I'm going to share this next part with you. This is straight from my prayer journal. And so here is what the Lord said. He said, keep pressing into me. He says, as you rest, and in that place of rest, God says that you will receive revelation of every barrier in your life to you walking in consistent peace. I'm going to say that again. God says, keep pressing into Him. As you rest in the secret place with Him, you will receive revelation of every barrier, and these are generally internal barriers. Barriers or obstacles to your peace, the foundational rocks of fear. So when we don't rest in His presence and we don't gain His perspective, then we tend to see our natural world through natural eyes. So we see it through our five senses from a very natural human perspective. But God says, not by might, not by power, but by my Spirit, says the Lord. That is how you will have victory. So again, as you keep pressing into the Lord, and then He says, and then once you've received that revelation, rest again in His presence. You will then be filled to overflowing with everything that you need. It is from that place of rest that you can have complete victory over all fear. So sometimes the Lord speaks to me in pictures. Sometimes we call those visions or dreams. I get both of them. I think the Bible says that young men see visions and old men see dreams, and I see both. So I must be in between young and old. But anyway, here is a picture that I saw. So I saw a glory cloud of God's presence falling and resting upon His sons and daughters. And as it began to fall upon them, it began to surround them continuously. And as that mantle or that glory cloud of His rest, of His kabod, of His peace began to fall upon His sons and daughters, we became overwhelmed with His goodness, His grace, His mercy, His anointing, riches, healing, joy, strength, peace, and miracles from God. And so that is the place, proverbially speaking, that God wants you to live from every single day. We don't have to wait until we see him face to face in heaven to live in that tangible reality, okay? But back to our topic of overcoming fear. The only way that we can do that is by finding that tangible encounter with God on a daily basis. And as we do that, he will begin to speak to the areas of our life where fear has crept in and created a stronghold. Now, I do want to give you an example of someone in the Old Testament who had a stronghold of fear. If you've never read the story of Job, I suggest that you go and read the story. It's a very small book in the Bible, in the Old Testament. And Job was a very righteous man, and he loved God and he served God. He was very wealthy, very prosperous, and very influential. But one day, Satan tested him, and all kinds of calamities came upon him in one day's time. And as that happened, Job said, "What I feared the most has come upon me." Now, even though Job was a righteous man who honored God, he inadvertently, because he was human, he allowed a particular fear to not only creep in, but then begin to grow in its intensity. And then he said, "What I have feared the most has come upon me." And so what I want you to understand is that Satan knows your greatest fears, and he capitalizes on them all the time. I've come to a place where I no longer get frustrated when certain areas of my faith are challenged. And I'll tell you why. It used to scare the bejeebies out of me. And I was like, "I don't want to do this. I just want all of this, you know, anxiety to go away, blah, 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 blah." But eventually, as I grew in the Lord, he said, "Dawn," he goes, "I'm just making you aware of the things in your life that need to come underneath the umbrella of my peace, that need to come underneath the umbrella of my grace and my love for you." And he says, "And if you will press into those things instead of backing off, instead of cowering away and saying, 'I don't want to deal with it,'" he said, "if you will just press into me," he goes, "I'll give you every revelation that you need to overcome it." I was like, "Ooh, okay, Jesus, let's do this." And so one of my flagship product of coaching and counseling is something called 21-Day Mindset Reset. And in there, basically, we learn one of the secrets of the law of attraction. So the truth of the matter is, you don't get in life what you want. You get in life what you are. And remember, I told you that from God's perspective, we're supposed to be, in other words, we're supposed to know our identity. From that place of identity, we know what our inheritance is. We know what gifts, callings, talents, skills that God has given us. And then we actually walk out those assignments from that place of identity. But sometimes we've experienced a lot of crazy things in life that has hampered or sometimes completely demolished our true identity as a beloved son of God, who is made in his image, created in his likeness, and endued with his power, right? So what we have to do is, if we're going to stop attracting fearful, anxious circumstances into our life, internally, we have to come out of agreement with fear. And that's what this podcast is about. And if you will follow me on social media, I'm going to share that when we wrap up here in a few minutes. But one of the secrets of the law of attraction is the law of confession through repetition. So when you have an area in your life where you do not feel secure, like last week we talked about, there were two responses from somebody who lost their job. And if you didn't hear that podcast, make sure that you go back. It's episode number 3. And so we talked about how one person had a completely different reaction than the other person. One person reacted in fear and cowardice and anxiety and worry. And the other person reacted in strength, trust in God, faith in God, knowing that God would use what the enemy had meant for evil, that God would use it for their good. They just responded in a completely different way. And so what is it that makes one person able to respond to a seemingly fearful or yucky situation, what is it that enables one person to respond from the identity and the place of God's grace and goodness and love and provision, and yet causes another person to completely respond from a place of lack or cowardice or a place of weakness or victimization? Well, the difference is the first person, they know who they are. They know whose they are, and they know that there is literally no situation, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. The enemy is like a prowling lion roaming around seeking whom he may devour. That means that not everybody is devourable. He's just trying to see who he can devour. So one of the secrets of the law of attraction to attract those things that you desire, that you know that God has for you, is the power of confession and repetition. It's something that I teach very much in intricate detail in my 21-day mindset reset coaching program. Now, I'm not going to go into it today, but what it does is it helps you to destroy every stubborn mindset block, and fear and anxiety is definitely a stubborn mindset block in many of our lives. I also teach you how to stop making negative judgments. So I'll give you an example from last week, the first person who was told, you know, that the company was letting them go because they were downsizing. How did that person respond? They said, well, God must be opening a new door for me. God must want to bless me with something different. Maybe this is a period of transition for me and I'm going to walk into something greater. So whenever you have any perceivable negative circumstance that comes near you, I want to challenge you to make no negative judgments. And what I mean is, I be careful what words come out of your mouth, because whatever you say, you will receive a harvest back of that 100-fold. I'm going to kind of wrap this up and close this with this here. As we are seeking to walk in peace and to literally obliterate, annihilate, and destroy every amount of fear, doubt, worry, anxiety, or unbelief in our life, I want to encourage you to challenge yourself to make no negative judgments. No negative judgments in your head, no negative judgments in your emotions, and definitely no negative judgments in your words. Okay, so if you would like to learn more about how you can become more than a conqueror and literally annihilate and cut the head off of every single doubt, fear, anxiety that you might have, I definitely want to encourage you to follow me. I have a 6-week mastermind course on overcoming fear, and I want to encourage you to go find me on the World Wide Web. You can go to dawnchurchill.org, or you can go to dawnchurchillinstitute.teachable.com. Now, if you have any questions, I want you to know you're more than welcome to reach out to me personally. My email address is dawnchurchillministries@gmail.com. And in addition to following me here on loveradionetwork.com, I also want to invite you to follow me on YouTube. So if you just go to YouTube and you Google my name, Dawn Churchill, you will find me. And so as we close this out, I just want to speak a quick word of peace over you today. And I pray that you will walk in the magnificence of God's love and joy and peace for you. So in the name of Jesus, Father God, everyone under the sound of my voice, I pray, Lord God, that you would, I pray windows of heaven blessings over their lives right now. I decree an open heaven over each one of them, where they would find easy access into your presence, that they would boldly approach your throne of grace with great confidence, knowing that they are a beloved son or daughter of you, Lord, in whom you are well pleased. I pray in the name of Jesus that from that place of knowing how loved and cherished and valued and treasured they are to you, Lord God, that they would begin to be able to open up their mind, will, and emotions to every aspect of your desire to bless them and bless them abundantly. Father God, in Jesus' name, I thank you, Lord God, that the spirit of wisdom and revelation will rest upon each one of them, that by by your Holy Spirit's unction and revelation in their lives as they seek you in the secret place, that you will reveal to them every single barrier to their peace, that you will reveal to them every single way in which the enemy has brought fear, anxiety, doubt, or unbelief into their life. And I thank you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that according to your mighty working power that is within them, according to the fact that they have the mind of Christ and it is your desire that they walk in soundness of mind, I thank you, Father God, in Jesus' name, that you will quickly bring to resolution every area of fear, doubt, worry, or unbelief, and that you will empower them and enable them to live a victorious life here in the earth as a beloved son or daughter who is made in your image, clothed in your likeness, anointed with your spirit and power, and empowered with skills, talents, gifts, and abilities to literally fill the earth with your glory and extend your kingdom everywhere they go. I pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, you guys, until next week, make sure that you follow me on all of those platforms, and I can't wait to share again with you on how you can overcome fear in every area of your life.